Hello student, welcome to our online practical class. Today I'm going to discuss the last topics of paper 2. As you know, in first term and second term we finish three topics like database, word processing and presentation. So this is the last topics left in paper 2, that is mail merge. Before starting the question paper, I want to give you some simple concept of mail merge. For example, if you want to invite 500 students from different school for your school program, that time you need to type 500 letter and 500 addresses also, right? It's very boring job. So this type of job we can do in simple way with the help of mail merge option in Microsoft Word. So that is the basic concept of mail merge. But in Cambridge, they will not ask you to do that type of thing. They will give you everything like letter, as well as they will give you some addresses. You have to connect those and you have to do according to their question. Let's start with one question paper, that is May-June 2017, variant 2-1. I made a duplicate copy of that question paper in my BIS folder in my laptop desktop. So you will do the same thing in your house. So first open the question paper. Basically, mail merge is the last part of the question, like task 4. So you have to go a little bit down. So you'll see in question number 31, I think, if I am not wrong, exactly 31. So task 4 is a mail merge. Let's start with our question. You are required to carry out a mail merge to produce a letter for a student who have been accepted on a course of study at Tawara Summer School. Use the file j217acceptlet.rtf as the master document for the mail merge and the file j217classlist.csv as the data source. Now here, what is master document means and what is data source means? Master document means the main letter or application which one you are going to send. And data source means in this file all the addresses is given. So first we have to open the master document. Then we have to connect the data source with the master document. So let's start from my data file, that is 2-1. Here is my master document. When you open your master document, you will see some word is blocked by chevron sign. This left hand sign, like less than sign and greater than sign, is called chevron sign. This one is called chevron sign. So these are the field which one you need to merge. Okay, after opening your master document, what you have to do, you have to connect with your data source, that means addresses. For connecting, you have to go to mailing. If you click on mailing menu, that time you will see only one icon is activated, that is select recipient. So you have to click here and you will get three options here. As we have the data source, that means addresses, so we will click use existing list. And my file belongs to desktop, so I have to go to my desktop. Then my folder is BIS, inside the BIS 2-1. I have to add this class list. When it will be connected, you'll see some icon will be like activated, like this one is activated. Now my first job is over. Now let's go for the second job. What in the second question they're asking for? Replace the date with the field displays today's date in the format DDMMYY. That means date format should be like this. Now let's start with the date one. Block the date. Go to insert menu. Click quick part, like Microsoft Word processing we did like this way. Then you have to go to field. Then from the left side, from field dialog box, from the left side you will choose any option. Then press D to time. I am repeating D to time. Then you will see in the right side all date format is given. Now you have to search for DDMMYY. So this is the thing. So DDMMYY. If you check my cursor pointer, this is called DDMMYY. Okay, so then press OK. Now you will see first date, then month, then year came. Right, now let's go for the second third question. Insert relevant merge field from the data source file to replace the text in chevron that is field. I told you that this sign is called chevron sign, so you have to merge the field belongs to chevron sign. Now first one is title. Block the title, then go to mailing again, insert merge field, you'll see one option. When you connect the data source like addresses, all the field will come here from the address table or data source table. So first one is title. When you click title, you see that chevron signs change and first name came closer, right? So you have to give some space. After title, there should be some space. By pressing space button, you have to give some space. Then first name, block first name, insert merge field, first name, give space, and then block last name. This way you have to merge the field, insert the merge field. So last name. Now you see street came up. Now you have to press enter for making it down, because it was like this. Street, block street, insert merge field, street. Okay, then block area, insert merge field, area. Press enter because postcode came up. Block this postcode, insert merge field, postcode. Press enter, insert merge, block this country, insert merge field. Where is my country? This one is country. Now press some enter because something came up, one space came up, so you have to press enter for making it in previous format, previous position. Block title, same process, insert merge field, title, then last name, insert merge field, last name, then quotes, block quotes, insert merge field, then quotes, give space, start date, insert merge field, start date, space, duration, block duration, insert merge field, duration, give space, then tutor, block tutor, insert merge field, tutor. What is that? Tutor, the last one. Okay, room type, insert merge field, room type, give space, accom, that means I think accommodation, accom, yes, accom, insert merge field, accom, give space. Okay, please make sure that there is a particular space is there, because two word cannot be together, right? So there should be some space between each and every word. It's a common thing. Okay, now let's go for the next question. Replace the text candidate name with your name. Okay, let me write my name. Don't write my name, you have to write your name, because I'm a student. In the class when I discuss about writing the like name, center number, candidate number, that I used to write my name. So some students are there, they follow that thing, and in the exam time they also write their teacher's name. So it should not be, it should be your name, right? Okay, great. Now next question. Spell check and proofread the document. So how to do that? You have to go to reference, review, then spelling and grammar, click on that. Now you'll see that there showing some error in my name. Name cannot be wrong, so ignore all. Same thing Tawara, it cannot be wrong, ignore all. That's all. So spelling and grammar checking is over. Now let's go for the next one. Display the field codes. So how to display the field codes? I'm telling you one secret thing, one shortcut key for the field codes. So no need to learn the difficult thing, that one. one shortcut key is there, Alt F9. If you press Alt F9 by keeping your cursor pointer anywhere in the body of the text, body of the letter, press Alt F9. Then you'll see all the merge field became some code. They're asking that one only. Okay. Now evidence 10. Place in your evidence document a screenshot showing the code for the format of the date field. So they're asking only date field code. So suppose this is my evidence document. Let's open one evidence document. Page layout should be narrow. Right, let's write down in 12 point. It will be big. Everything should be visible in the evidence document. Evidence 10. So after this one, you have to give the screenshot of only the date part. So what you will do, you'll increase this one little bit by clicking this plus sign. Okay, then press print screen button. You can use print screen also, even snipping tool also. So I prefer to use print screen. It is totally your wish which one you are going to use. Now don't take the whole thing. You have to take only the date part. Now you have to crop this picture. How to do that? You see, no format menu is given in Microsoft Word. So how to get the format menu? When you click the picture, automatically format menu will come. Did you see that? Check, click on picture and format menu is there. So go to format menu, select crop option, and then crop this picture. Like up to date, not the whole thing. Don't take the whole thing, because in the question paper they are asking only the date part. So now you can increase the size. It should be visible, and make sure that date format is given properly. Sometimes the date format is not there, but code is there, so that is not acceptable. So the date format should come DD MMYY. Examiner is asking that one only. Okay, now press enter. You can go for the next evidence. Minimize this one. Okay, now next question. Next question, we can go for the printout 4. Print your master document with the merge field displayed. Make sure that you have entered your name, center number. Oh, I think I missed one question, right? Include your center number, candidate number in the footer of the document. So, see, I missed one question. So, you have to print your master document with the merge field displayed. Make sure that you have entered your name, center number and candidate number on your document. So they're asking insert merge field. So maximum student do mistake here. They take the printout of this one. Actually, this one is not the printout. You have to insert the merge field. So not the code. They're asking the merge field. So what I have to do first? First, I have to make it in previous format. That is, I have to press Alt F9 again. Now see, it is the combination of merge field. Now here in the bottom of the letter, I have to give my center number, name, center number, candidate number. In the question paper, if you check, I missed the question. Some reason is there. In the question paper, if you check, include your center number and candidate number in the footer of the document. They only mention two. But as a student, what you will do, you will write three things: name, center number, candidate number. Sometime examiner miss your name from here. So examiner can check easily. So everything should be visible for the examiner. For that reason, you will, in the footer of the document, you will write your name also. So what, how to do that? Insert, click on footer, select the second option, in the left side write your name. You know our center number is for boys SA139 and for girls SX139, and candidate number you will get after your registration. Suppose now candidate number is 1234. Click inside. Now you see everything is visible. Now you have to take the printout according to your question paper. In your question paper, that is printout 4, they're asking this page printout only, not the code. I am repeating it again. Maximum student do mistake. They print with code like this. No, this you should not print with code. They're asking print. See the question again. See the question again. What they are asking? Print your master document with the merge field. They are asking the merge field, not the code of the merge field, right? So you have to take the printout of this one. That's all for up to this. Okay, now come to the point. Question number 32. Merge the letter selecting only those students who have been accepted on the course medieval studies with the duration 3 weeks. Now you have to do some apply some condition here. So they are asking on the course, that means course should be medieval studies and duration is 3 weeks. Okay, let's start. So here again you have to go to the mailing, as you have to write some condition. So click edit recipient. That means only those recipient will get this letter. So now it is very difficult to find out which one is course. First check, you have to check yourself whether there is any field like course or not. If you go for this right side, you will see course is there. And another condition was duration. Check for the duration. Also duration is there. So you have to write some condition in the filter option. So click on filter. Here it should be, field name should be, first one is course, right? It should be equal to that medieval studies. The spelling should be correct according to the question paper, otherwise you will get wrong answer. So this is my compared to, that means equal, it should be equal to medieval studies. And here is the question. Here student do maximum mistake. Some student here mention or, some student mention and. The question is that when you have to mention and when you have to mention or. When you see they are asking data from same field, like here is course. If they ask another course, that time you have to give or. That means if they ask some data from the same field, that time you have to give or. But if it is different field, that time you have to give and. Right? Again, I am repeating. If they are asking the data from different field, that time you have to give and. But if they are asking data from same field, that time you have to give or. So in that case, if I check the question paper, first field is course, second field is duration. That means they are asking data from different field. So I have to give here and I have to mention here duration equal to duration of 3 weeks. Just write down 3, right? Then press OK. Word could not merge the main document with the data. So it's because the data recorded were empty. Okay. So that means we did some mistake is there. So this one is course equal to, again write, okay, and duration equal to 3. Now you will get the answer. Earlier time maybe we did some mistake, that's why it was not coming. So please keep it in your mind, if they are asking data from different field, that time you have to give and. If they are asking the data from same field, that time you have to give or. So now press OK. Now see, three data came, like three letter will come actually. Now check the second next part of this question. Place in your evidence document the screenshot showing your selecting method. Again, student do mistake here. They only just take the screenshot of this one. No, you have to take the screenshot of filter part also. How you wrote the condition, that one also you have to show. So you will keep this one as a background picture, the down one, and front one should be the condition, right? Okay, now then you have to take the screenshot. Press print screen. Then press OK, otherwise you cannot go to your evidence document. And this is evidence 11, I think. This is evidence 11. So you have to go to your evidence document, write down evidence 11, control V, Now select the picture. The same way you have to crop this picture, because the right side and left side is not needed, even the upper part. You have to just show the how you wrote the condition, that thing you have to show. So yeah, done. And this screen should be visible properly. Okay, next question. We can go for the next question. What next question is asking? Print only the merge letter for the selected students. Print out 5. Print the result of the merge Make sure that you have entered your name, center number, and candidate number on your letter. Now check that thing. So how to merge finally how to merge the fields according to our condition. So you have to go to the main documents, then you have to click here, finish merge from mailing menu, finish merge, and edit individual document, click here. Now this merge to new document dialog box will come. Make sure that it is selected all and then press OK. Now see, those three person name will come and three separate letter will come. Now you have to just print it. Before printing, just make sure that your name, center number, and candidate number is given properly, right? That's all for this question paper. If I am not wrong, let me check. Any question is left? No. Save the and close the document. That's all. Thank you. And please try to do variant 2, which one I'm going to upload, or it is already uploaded. Please try to do variant 2, and if you have any question, like, you can ask the question by giving your comments. Thank you.